Hi, I'm Louise from the Ontario Science Centre, and today I'm going to be talking about the science of laundry. I'm sure all of us, at one point or another, have gotten a stain on our clothes. And what do you do when that happens? Now, sometimes when we do this, the stain doesn't come out completely, and you're left with a permanent stain. And that's sad, because this could be one of your favorite pieces of clothing. So how can we avoid this? We're going to be doing an experiment to find out what the best conditions are for removing different types of stains. Now, in any experiment, there are constants that stay the same throughout the experiment, and then there are variables that we can change one at a time to find out what the effect of each variable is. In this experiment, one of the constants will be the fabric that I'm washing. So I've taken an old cotton jersey t-shirt and I've sacrificed it. I've cut it up into a series of sample squares that I'll be washing. Another constant will be what we're washing with, water. We're going to need another piece of equipment, something to wash in. So I have a bowl here and something to mix with. I've got a spoon. This will be the stand-in for our washing machine. I'm going to be seeing what happens with a really common stain, an oil stain. So I have two pieces of sample fabric here with oil stains on them, and we're going to be washing them in water. But what happens when oil and water get together? You'll notice that the oil and water are not mixing. Instead, they're forming two separate layers. Oil and water are what we call immiscible. In order to understand why water and oil don't mix, let's take a closer look at their molecular structures. Water is H2O. One oxygen bonded with two hydrogens. Now each of these lines represents a chemical bond, and a chemical bond is made up of a shared pair of electrons. Oxygen has more electrons around it, which I'm drawing in. And remember that electrons have a negative charge, so that this end of the water molecule is relatively negative, and this end of the water molecule is relatively positive. What happens when we get water molecules together, I'll draw another one here, is that there is an attraction between the negative end of one water molecule and the positive end of another water molecule, like so. And this attraction is called a hydrogen bond. So when we get water molecules together, they're all held together with all of these hydrogen bonds. Water is what we call a polar substance. Oil, on the other hand, is made up of chemicals that have long chains of carbon atoms as their backbone. I'll draw one as an example. Now, all of these carbons are the same, and they're exerting the exact same amount of pull on their electrons, so that there's nowhere along this molecule which is more negative or positive than another part. Oil is what we call a nonpolar substance. Coming back to our stain removal experiment, temperature is going to be our first variable. I've got two sample squares with oil stains on them, and I'm going to wash one in cold water, which is around 10 to 12 degrees Celsius. So put this fabric sample in and mix it. And the other sample is going to be washed in hot water, which is 50 degrees Celsius or higher. Kids, if you're doing this, please have a grown-up do this for you. We're washing in a bowl because we don't want to put our hands in hot water. For the grown-ups, if you're not comfortable using hot water, you can always use warm water, which is between 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. Here are my two fabric squares, one washed in cold water and the other in hot water and air dried. For comparison, I've put two unwashed samples with oil stains so we can see what the stains look like before washing. As you can see, the oil stains after washing have gotten larger from the mixing and agitation, but overall the stains are still there in both samples. The sample washed in hot water is maybe a little bit lighter, but not by much. So let's keep experimenting to see if we can find some better conditions. Normally we don't wash clothes in water alone. We add laundry detergent. Here's my bottle. So what is it about detergent that makes it work? I'm going to draw a detergent molecule. It has a polar head group, which is hydrophilic. So it's attracted to water. But attached to that polar head group is a long non-polar tail that is hydrophobic. And it's attracted to oil. Detergent molecules are what we call amphiphilic. They have a dual nature. When we add laundry detergent to the water, what will happen is the non-polar tails of our detergent molecules will be attracted to the oil, while the polar head groups will face out towards the water. Remember, out here, it's all water. And here's the surface of my fabric. When we rinse everything away, what will happen is the oil will be inside of this bubble of detergent. See, here's our non-polar tails holding on to our oil. But the outside part, being hydrophilic, allows us to wash everything away. And that's how detergent works. This time I'm going to repeat the experiment by adding laundry detergent. And I'm going to put the laundry detergent right on the stain. And this will give a chance for the detergent molecules to stick right onto the oil. If I pour it directly into the water, then the detergent is going to get diluted and it may not come in contact with the stain. So here we go. We're going to wash one sample in cold water and another one in hot water, just like we did before. I've finished washing and drying my samples in water and detergent, one in cold water and the other in hot water. And for comparison, I've put the samples that were washed in water alone, so we can see the difference. Now, if we take a look at the sample washed in cold water and detergent, pretty much all of the stain has been removed. It's there, it's very faint, but pretty good. Now, if we take a look at the sample washed in hot water and detergent, the stain has been completely removed. Can't see anything. So it looks like the best conditions for removing an oil stain are with warmer water, the warmer the better, and with detergent. Next, we're going to try removing a really tough stain, egg yolk. Egg yolk contains a complex mixture of chemicals, including proteins and fats. Now, fats are generally non-polar, but what about protein? Proteins are used for all sorts of things in living organisms. In humans, they make up our skin, nails, hair. Proteins are made up of long chains of amino acids, which might be nonpolar or polar. Now remember, the bodies of living organisms are mostly water, and the same is true for the insides of the cells that make up those bodies, mostly water. Now proteins are assembled within a cell. So let's imagine that this pipe cleaner is a chain of amino acids that will make up a protein. As this protein is being assembled, the nonpolar amino acids are hydrophobic and they will want to hide away from the surrounding water, while the polar amino acids are hydrophilic. They will want to face towards the water. Now these forces help to shape proteins into their final working structure. So proteins have parts that allow them to be soluble in water, meaning they can be dissolved into water and they don't form a separate phase or layer. We can see this really well in the egg white. It is, for the most part, clear. We don't see clumps of proteins. But I'm sure most of you have seen what happens when we cook an egg. The egg white goes from clear to opaque white, and the egg yolk goes from this shiny bright yellow to this dull, opaque, pale yellow. This change happens because as we heat up the egg, the proteins start to change. Remember, as we're heating, we're increasing molecular motion. The water molecules surrounding this protein start moving around a lot more. So do the proteins. And the forces holding the internal structure of this protein together start to diminish. The nonpolar amino acids that are hidden inside become exposed. So you can see this protein is changing its shape. Now let's say there's another protein nearby that has undergone the same change, and what will happen is the nonpolar parts of each protein will want to stick together because those nonpolar amino acids are hydrophobic. They want to hide away from the surrounding water. So this is forming a clump, and this clump is called a protein aggregate, which is insoluble in water. So we see this change in the egg white. We start off with proteins that are soluble in water, so the white looks clear. And then
As we heat, as we cook the egg, the white turns opaque as the proteins aggregate and they are no longer soluble in water.
I'm going to be repeating the same experiment I did with the oil stains. So here are my fabric samples with egg yolk on them, and I'm going to be washing the first set in water alone. So as before, one sample in cold water, which is around 11 degrees Celsius, and the other in hot water, which is around 50 degrees Celsius or higher. Now we're using a bowl, again, because we don't want to put our hands in hot water. Kids, if you're doing this, please have a grown-up help you out with this. And for the grown-ups, if you're not comfortable with hot water, you can use warm water, which is between 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. Now for the second set, we will be washing with detergent. And as we did it before, we'll be putting the detergent directly on the stain to make sure that the detergent has a chance to stick to the stain. And then we'll be washing one in cold water and one in hot water. Here are my fabric samples, washed and air dried. And for comparison, I have an unwashed sample with an egg yolk stain on it, so we can see what it looked like beforehand. Now, one set was washed in water alone, one in cold water, the other in hot water, and the other set was washed with detergent. Again, one in cold water and the other in hot water. Now, if we take a look at the one washed in cold water alone, that cold water managed to remove most of the stain. There's a very faint yellow stain left, and that's likely due to the fats and oils that are found in egg yolk. Remember that fats and oils are non-polar, so they are not miscible with water. This one was washed in hot water alone, and you can see there's a very definite dark yellow stain left behind. That's likely due to those insoluble protein aggregates, which are now stuck onto the fabric. This sample here was washed in cold water and detergent. And as you can see, pretty much all of the stain has been removed. I really can't see anything left behind. This one was washed in hot water and detergent. And most of the stain has been removed, but there's still this very definite yellow ring left behind. Again, that's likely due to those insoluble proteins stuck onto the fabric. So it looks like the best conditions for removing an egg yolk stain are cold water and detergent.
I hope you found this useful. Knowing about solubility, polarity, and how detergents work is really important because it applies to many other areas, not just laundry. Now, I have some tips for you. When you're washing your clothes, make sure to check the fabric care label. The manufacturer gives the ideal washing conditions for that particular garment, and caring for your clothes will extend their lifespan. If you do happen to get a stain on your clothes, don't wait for it to set. The longer you wait, the harder it will be to remove the stain. Now, if you have a stain and you have no idea what it is, I recommend pre-treating, and that's what I showed you earlier, where you put a little bit of detergent right on the stain, rub it in, and then wash it out. Start with cold water, because if that stain is protein-based and you start with hot water, you will form those insoluble protein aggregates, which are really hard to wash out. If you're working on getting out a stain, let it air dry, because if you use the laundry dryer, it may be pumping out hot air, and that hot air will also set the stain. Now, if you have some fabric scraps at home, try experimenting with other types of stains. We did oil and protein today, but there's other things you could try, maybe grass or blueberry. So I hope you have some fun experimenting and discovering. We'd love to see your results. Thanks so much for watching.